What can you do with some paper and a battery-operated candle? Well, you can make yourself a really fun nightlight utilizing built-in designs in the ScanNCut DX. I'm working on the 225 model, as you can see here, and I'm just going to go up and grab the Sweet Dreams word art that's already here in the machine and size it down because I want it to be about 4.5 inches wide, not too much more than that. And then I'm going to center it where I want to cut it because I'm going to want it to cut out of the center of my paper. Then I will go back in and select a star. And the reason I am selecting a star is because that's the design that I want to put all over for this nightlight. So once I have selected it, I will select a couple of them. And then I'm going to go into Object Edit, and resize each one to be, I just need about 3 different sizes. But I'm also going to increase the number, which will create a number of stars for me in each of the sizes that I would like. Some, the larger ones, fewer, and then I'm going to make some really small ones and make more of those. Once I've got those, I'm just dragging them all around in a design that I like around my Sweet Dreams. And once I have done that, I am then going to go into the next edit screen. As you can see, it's really easy to just drop and drag everything into place. I'm just really filling this field with stars, leaving some space, of course, but really getting it nice and full. Once I have done that, I go into Object Edit and the button with the little arrow so that I can rotate. So I'm going to be rotating not all of the stars, some of the stars, 10, 20, maybe even 30 degrees. And what this is going to do is just give a little more interesting look so that all the stars aren't exactly the same. Some of them are offset in different directions. Once I am done with this, I'm just going to click OK. And then I'm going to cut. I'm cutting a standard piece of cardstock out of this. And I'm going to go ahead and cut that out. And as you can see, it takes about 4 minutes. Once this is done, here you can see my cardstock. I'm not using the cut files that I made. I'm using the paper left behind. This is going to give us little spaces. And then I have a piece of star-designed vellum that you can see there to the side. I'm just getting all this adhesive because I want a really nice, firm grip on this. And then I'm going to set my vellum, which is see-through, down onto my cardstock. And what this will do, this step is optional, but what it's going to do is 2 different things. Number one, it's going to create a really fun pattern and design and detail to my project. But number two, it's also going to make it so, as you can see between Sweet and Dreams, there's a piece of paper that would be awfully nice to have in there because then it would actually show how those letters come together and it would actually make it so that the word was readable. So by having that vellum there, it allows me to adhere that and any other pieces that I would like onto here. Now, once I am done, all I'm going to need to do is roll this, glue it on top of my candle, and I can be done, unless there's any additional embellishing I would like. Super easy project. And that candle, by the way, that is battery operated. So this would be safe for camping as a nightlight in a room. You don't have to worry about it because there's no flame. It is a battery operated candle. And here I'll show you with it turned on. Isn't that pretty? All lit up like that. I just think it's going to be so, so cute. And I love how all the stars, especially, obviously I can't show you here at night because then our video wouldn't look very good, but it looks beautiful at night. So to add a little more fun, and because we can, since we aren't dealing with any flames or anything, I'm taking some string and I'm cutting a couple pieces of it. And then I'm going to take some of those stars. So we have all of those stars on our mat. Do not throw those away. Those will make excellent additions to future projects. Get all of those stars and get a couple that are similar size. So the same, you want the same, the larger ones with the large, the smaller ones with the small. And then go ahead and put 2 of them on each end of the ribbon. And what this is going to do is it's just going to create a fun little dangling element that we can put off the top of our project. And once this is done, you're going to go ahead and tie a knot in the top. And if you want to add anything else, buttons or sequins or additional little doodads to your nightlight, you certainly could. I'm going to dangle this. I'm going to just hot glue it there to the top of my project. And then I also have a little red ribbon bow that I think would be really cute on there that I'll add as well with a little bit of hot glue. And voila, we have our finished nightlight candle. I hope you've enjoyed this simple project with the ScanNCut DX. Be sure to subscribe to the Brother YouTube channel. And of course, always stay tuned for more because we're always coming back with fun new projects and ideas to create with your ScanNCut DX.